Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. To music now, they are hip-hop legends, the Samoan brothers raised in Carson, California, who became synonymous with LA hip-hop and the gangster rap scene of the 1980s.
Now 30 years on, they've mellowed out a bit, but still get together for the odd jam. Recently, they were in Auckland for Ragamuffin, and big fan Jeremiah Tauamiti got to hang out with the Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E.
They're a group that's inspired a generation of Pacific entertainers, and everybody in the industry has heard of them. The Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E.
I would have been 8 at the time, I think. And as we were leaving the lounge, the TV was on the music channel. And I had Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E. playing. So I remember looking, and then my brother was like, hey, those guys are Samoan. So we stopped and watched the whole thing. You know, it was that song, Rape.
When the first time I saw Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E.? Rape!
Yep, back when we was first coming out.
First coming out.
Yep. Exactly.
A little before us,
Boo-Yaa,
right?
Boo-Yaa.
Boo-Yaa was a word we used to say on the East, too, like, you know.
And we always respected the Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E., yo.
Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E. is big, you know what I'm saying? They're legendary, yeah. I saw them for the first time, of course, in Los Angeles first. You know, you can't miss the big the big Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E. fellas rolling through, because they roll deep and they really, really proud of what they do and who they are. And everybody in LA respects that.
Los Angeles, a long way from the islands, but as always, like most of us, their journey started in the church.
We had a big church at that time, so, you know, so my dad was like, you know, pick up instruments, because, you know, he's one of the pastor's kids, so he ain't just gonna get anyone else.
We would go early to church and jam like some Commodores with Brick House. Bump, 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 bump. Hell, the church people's coming. And then we go back into the church song. Dun, dun. Youngest band in the Assembly of God. Everyone had all the OGs from everywhere, older guys. We were all like little kids. My dad said, play for God. And that was history from there on. We never stopped.
And despite being involved with some of the biggest names in the entertainment industry, this humility keeps them grounded with their fellow Pacific artists.
When they all say, Boo-Yaa, you're the first in the music. No, we ain't. The Jets are the first to sign a major
deal.
They're Tongans.
We give them props.
Those are the Tongans.
We were the first in hip-hop.
We were just the first gangsters of the streets to come from the, you know. But
Jets were the first, you know.
Let's give credit where it's all done, you know. Because that's something that I can take to the blacks, the Mexicans, and the whites and go, hey, this is our music. You know, when you're driving down, you hear the mariachis from the Mexicans. You want to hear rap? Okay, that's Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E. But you want to hear some more music? You know, put that 5-star on, you know, that's our music.
They stayed true to their culture and music, but they stayed true to the streets as well. Strutters or dancers before there were Boo-Yaa, but also gangsters. And sadly, they lost their older brother Rob to the streets as well.
The day Rob died was the day that the day music saved Red too, because Red was rapping.
These guys wanted me.
Yeah. You know,
my brother went to go, you know, use the restroom, and then I was flowing against some fools, like rap, and I just heard the gunshots, and they plugged my brother right there, you know?
They mistaken my brother Rob for Red, and first time we ever talked about this, since 88 he passed away, and we don't talk about it, but
never turned back,
you know?
And then our second time, when my brother Gotti got shot like 7 times, close range, but if he would have died, I don't think we'll be here today. Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E., you know? We turned our cheek on the first one. That was my brother Rob, you know? But when my brother Gotti got shot, it was like, if he goes, it's over. We wouldn't be here today. Yeah. But hey, we thankful.
So the brothers regrouped and the artists keep coming. Janet Jackson, Faith No More, Always Hustling, even the biggest name in rap at the time, Eminem.
Meeting Eminem, for him to even acknowledge us, we had spit the first clip, and all I remember, I seen Eminem. He was looking for his gloves. He put his gloves on, put his hood, and he was just bobbing, and his eyes closed like this. And he got up, he hugged me, he goes, man, the world need to hear you, man.
Brother D, let's go! Brother D, let's roll!
These boys, Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E., represented us many years ago, you know, in the music. We saw Samoa, you know? And so that made us proud. Well, we were proud of them, so we used to drive around and bump their music, you know?
You know, I grew up to their music, and I think it was from there that really triggered in my mind that it's possible for a Pacific Islander to do music and to be on TV, you know. That was a big eye-opener for me as a kid.
I think for me, they just see a family. Whether it's everyone thinks it's the gang thing, I think they just saw me and my brothers always together, you know. We still the only rap group as a family still together, you know. The Jackson 5s broke up, not the DeVoe brothers.
And it's that message of Ayinga that's kept their peers and fans loyal to the Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E. Today, members from two different gangs united to provide lunch and gifts as a sign of respect to the musical pioneers.
You know, me and my brothers, you know, we got emotional. You know, you don't get that in America. When we come here, this is one of our best places to come to tour is here, man, because we see the Polys, you know, everyone gets along, you know what I mean? And it teaches us too when we go back, you know, to be more humble. You know, it doesn't matter what about rags or this or that, and like I can't wait to go home and just tell everyone there, our Poly people, like, man, we need a lot of learning, man. We need a lot of adjustment to do because New Zealand got their thing right, man. Here I see unity, man. It's nothing but love, you know, especially for you guys, man. Thank you, man.
Love, peace. Booyah.
Good to see the Boo-Yaa T.R.I.B.E. still doing their thing. Well, sadly, that's the end of our show for today. Thank you for joining us. You can catch any of our stories again on TVNZ On Demand or Facebook.
Make sure you tune in next week. We'll have the Usa Bikers, their inspiring journey across New Zealand.
Have a wonderful weekend and happy Easter for next weekend too.
Till